I think they've got the momentum enough that they really can push through with this.
I think a lot of the game now depends on Markis Kido. He definitely lost concentration in the second set after he was called for the foul service. And it's whether he can get himself sorted out and get himself back on track.
Oh, yeah, that's nice. But I think that Kenneth Jonasson was saying to the Danish pair, look, come on, you've got to focus on not hitting hard the whole time. He was talking about stick smashes, as the Danes call them, which is these very angled smashes, and also guiding the shuttle.
Yes, I think Kenneth will be disappointed with the first game of this set, where they've put pace on and played the Indonesian game and let Kido get into the third set very, very early.
Service over. 1-2.
Low serve is short of the mark.
Service over, 3-1.
Just didn't have any backswing on his serve there, did he? Didn't push through it enough either. I wonder if that was nerves.
He's certainly a player who's had troubles over the years with his short service and doubles. He goes through periods where he almost completely loses it, a little bit like some of the darts players sometimes have.
Turn is long of that back line.
3-all.
Complete contrast with Lars. Very, very solid on service. Very rarely makes any service mistakes and makes the opponents play the whole time.
Yeah, it's beautiful, isn't it? Just calmly sees the gap across court, sees the open space, and calmly just guides the shuttle into that area of the court.
Yes, I think that's the key for the Indonesians, whether Setiawan can impose himself on this game, because he's coming out with some super touches. But his partner just looks a little bit frantic at times. Markis Kido, maybe it's the injuries, maybe he's not had a lot of match play, but he certainly looks a little bit stressed in this match.
There's real power and real urgency in the Indonesian style of play, that last rally. Because you're right, in that second game, they did go strangely passive. Seemed a little too laid back, and of course the Danes took every advantage of that.
Yes, if the Indonesians drop the pace at all, Lars will be getting in and taking control of the front court, and that changes the game completely.
Oof, indecision. And points towards the line, as if to say, well, I know I should have left that.
Start of this third set, we're seeing a little change from the Danes as well. They're starting to hunt Markis Kido early in the rallies. They're trying to cut Setiawan out of the game a little bit here.
Rasmussen was a bit loose that low serve, but because he had guided it out wide, something a little bit different angle to deal with, forced the error. But I think in a way you're right, because that looked like a snatch shot from Markis Kido, and I think almost sort of panic is setting in because he so desperately wants to win this. Of course, they've been world champions, are Olympic champions, but the Indonesians have never actually won this All-England title, and they desperately want it.
They'll be wanting to follow some of the very famous Indonesian names who have won this title. We've got a great tradition in the All England men's doubles.
Lars Paaske hasn't missed many of these, I can tell you, throughout this match. That really was a golden opportunity. It's the Danes that are looking a little bit ragged.
It's a test of nerve now, particularly around the first three shots. Return of serve from Lars, stepping in, taking the shuttle early. Earned the net cord.
Clever smashing. Saw that Markis Kido was committed to that backhand defence and therefore smashing slightly across the body towards his right hip. Real precision on the placement of the smash. Back level. Oh dear.
Certainly looks like it's Markis Kido is feeling the pressure here at the moment. One or two very, very simple mistakes from him.
Four straight points on the Paaske serve. At the mid-game interval, the narrowest of possible margins, just 1 point in it, could not be closer. Now the Danes have the favoured end because every pair have from that far end in this men's doubles semi-final have done better for that far side of the court.
Yes, it seems all the players are a little bit more comfortable with the timing from that end.
Spring in the step of Lars Paaske. There's real confidence just oozing from him. Good anticipation, Setiawan at his best.
And for the Indonesians to win this, Setiawan really needs to try and take control of this game now. The one area that Kido's done reasonably well since the foul serve, he has managed to keep his serve going, which gives Setiawan a chance to get into the rallies.
Good judgment.
13-12.
Danger, of course, when you sense that your partner is having a rough time and you try and do too much. Because you want to influence the game, you want to try and take the lion's share of the work, and then you try and overdo it. So they've got to be careful not to allow that to happen.
Yes, yes, it's becoming a very mental game, this third game. It's who's going to stand up under the pressure. Of lack of confidence. I mean, he could have been a little bit more patient there, tried to get his partner in, but went for the direct winner from the rear court, and at this level, that's a big ask. This is possibly a situation where they're missing being part of the system, having an experienced coach behind them, just trying to calm Markis down, just telling him to keep to the basics. Because at the moment he's making some very, very poor decisions during the rallies, poor choices of shots. In that rally, Kido really did step up to the mark and hit a lot of incredible shots, but the Danes stood firm and Lars was able to finish in the end.
15-13.
Well, the Danish fans behind the court in fine voice now. That's a good return from Rasmussen.
16-14.
Probably two of the best field court players in the world of badminton.
Absolutely, absolutely. I mean, we saw in the long rally that we had 2 points ago that with Kido at the front, Kido had one or two opportunities to finish, but just isn't as clinical as Setiawan in the forecourt.
The decision to leave it was just wide.
Over. 17-15.
Flatter smash across the body of Paaske, chest height.
It's over. 16-17.
Yes, Setiawan taking a slight risk, but I think he's got to do that now.
This is all desperately close. One game all, 17 all in the deciding game. Who's got the nerve?
Setiawan again, just taking control of the last couple of points. The big points are arriving, and it's Setiawan who's stepping up to the mark at the moment.
18-17.
It's a great backhand from the net from Setiawan. As you say, pouncing on the opportunity then to finish it off. The judge went, left it, and it was wide. 2 points away from a place in the final for the pair who prior to this year had never got past the second round. Good anticipation from Lars Paaske. He was moving forward to the net before Markis Kido actually hit the drop shot. Look, he's already gone forward. Just sense what shot was coming. Because there was no indication at the time he started to move, there was no indication of what shot was going to be played.
No, it's about standing up and taking responsibility now on these big points. And Setiawan had done it in the three previous points. He'd taken a chance, stepped forward, taken control of forecourt, managed to find winning shots. And Lars realised that he'd got to do a similar sort of thing. And he certainly did it very effectively there.